What's going on, guys? It's your boy Adjen back again for another Outer Plane video. And for today, I'm gonna be sharing with you everything I know about Tamamo no Mae. Her best build, her best gears, her best team builds, yada yada. Just take note that these are just based on my opinions and by my playtesting with her. So just take it with a big grain of salt. It's already been long overdue for this guide to come out, but I really have to test her out first in PBE and PBP so that I can give you my unbiased review about her. First and foremost, Tamamo no Mae is not a mass summon. Yes, she is not a mass up unless you are simping for her. You are a Tamamo no Mae simp. Then if she's your waifu and you really really like her design, then go ahead and summon for her. No one is stopping you. But in a meta person's perspective, she is not a meta character in PvP, but in PvE she's really really that good. That is my too long did not watch for you guys. So in PvP she's meh, in PvE she's really good. Now let us talk about her skill set. Tamamo no Mae skill set are really meant for PvE, but should you max out all of her skill set? I think the only one that needs to be maxed out here, skill 3 and skill 2 are really really good. Maybe skill 3 only up to level 4 and then skill 2 up to level 5. So her skill 3, this one is an AoE attack. It grants HOT debuff, the sustained recovery. This is the heal over time. So she is somewhat like a pseudo support, pseudo healer category. So the roll compression on her kit is really good for PvE stops. You really don't need to bring a dedicated healer if you have her on the team. Based on my playtesting with her in PvE, she's already good enough with this kind of sustained recovery. So you don't really need a healer. You don't need the Tio, who is the other 3-star healer, Astey. Tamamo no Mae is already pretty good enough. And not only she can do sustain for your team with this skill, this one also is really good because this one gives you an additional 15 chain points. Chain points is very very OP in PvE stops because you can spam chain points and you can spam chain skills. And her chain skill is also really darn good. That is why I think she's really that good in PvE. And also she is a HP scaler, so do not build her with attack. Her main stat should be priority is probably, in my honest opinion, her main stat priority is speed plus HP, and then the rest are pretty much negligible. It's very optional. She's really really easy to build. You only need speed and HP on her. That is my best build for her. Her skill 2 is a counter attack. This one, when an ally is hit, counterattacks with Nirvana's Inferno. So the Nirvana's Inferno triggered effect, before attacking, removes 2 buffs from the target and reduces evasion for 2 turns. If the target is Earth Element, ignores the resilience and does not miss. Damage dealt increases proportional to max health instead of attack. The very noticeable boss that comes to mind when you read this skill set is the Twin Beetle. The Twin Beetle has some buffs, especially the invulnerability buff. And also, they have some evasion buff. And if you get hit by Twin Beetle, then she will activate this one. She will remove those buffs and also inflicts minus evasion, reduce evasion to the enemy. So she's really meant to counter those Twin Beetles. But she's also really good in Chimera. If you've seen my Tamamo no Mae's PBE showcase, I've showcased her in those hunts. She's really that good. And her skills are really really meant for PBE. She's not really that good in PvP, even though she's somewhat a true scaler like Demidrakan and Kanon. It must be that her damage multiplier may be on the low side. That is why even if you build her with a really high HP, her damage still sucks. Her skill 1 normal attack, I don't think this one is a really good investment to max out. I just maxed this one out for the showcase. But if you are a beginner or a mid game player, Resources, skill books are still very scarce for you. There are better way, there are better heroes for you to prioritize in using those skill books, especially the red ones. So this one is not a, I think it's just a luxury to max this one out. Especially if you're Atama mo no Maisim, you will max this all of her skill set. This one only do the level 2. Always do the level 2 unless they are your main DPS or if you are really really lacking in some damage. But I don't think right now in the game you will lack that much damage because of the quirks. Yeah, upgrading your quirks in the base system also helps a lot in clearing PvE stuff. So that is why PvE nowadays are very very easy. I'm just waiting for the new joint challenge and then the launch of the world boss because those are probably the most anticipated end game PvE contents in Outer Plane. Now, as I've said, let us go to the builds. I build there with speed set. Why speed set? Because the higher her speed is, the more turns she will get, the more turn cycle she will get, and having to turn cycle real fast is really good in PvE, especially because you will be gaining more and more chain points. And once you've gotten a lot of chain points, you can spam the chain skill. By the way, I forgot the chain skill. Chain skill is a fixed damage HP cut, 8% HP cut. This is the second highest HP cut in the game. Only the highest one is Distella, which is 10%. Yeah. The other ones, the non-premium characters, they are all at around 8% only. But still, that 8% HP cut is still very, very strong, especially against bosses that has a lot of HP. For example, the bosses in the Gias bosses in Guild Raids. That is why HP cut or fixed damage dealers units are highly rated in Guild Raids because of those skill sets. And Tama Mo no Mai has them. That is why I will be rating her at the not really the broken tier, but below that one, probably at around S plus tier or S tier, something like that. If I'm going to be updating my PvE tier list right now, that is what I'm gonna be rating her. So speed set, just not really the speed set that I'm currently wearing is not the best. These are just my spare speed set, and I have a 255 speed already here, so it's really really hard, really that easy to gear her. You also don't need red gear for her because usually the red gears, the passive effect from them, the unique effect from the red gears favors the DPS type mages, and she's not a DPS, she's not a dedicated DPS character, and that is why having these red characters are just for stat boost, like for example the HP main, because red gears has the highest HP main if you break through this one, and also same with the necklace here. You will get more speed main stat if you use red gears. That is the only advantages of using red gears on the weapon and the accessory. But even if you have a blue one is pretty much very easy to grind. So if you have those, then those are pretty much very okay to her. She's not really stat hungry because she is a support, and usually support only needs what they're meant to do, to spam their skill sets. That is why I'm suggesting that you build her with speed. Now, let us talk about the team building. Wait, I forgot the talisman. Talisman is best for is the Sage Charm. If you will be using her against earth enemies or earth stages. Excuse. This one is the best talisman for her. Generates 10 chain points. Rogue's Charm might be good also, but Rogue's Charm needs you to critical hit, do some critical hit with your attacks. So there is a case where she will not be hitting critical hits unless you build her with critical a high crit rate, but this one is still the best in my honest opinion for PvE stops. Her exclusive equipment, I think it's only good for if you want to have some more gems on her. The damage is increases boss damage of fire element. Oh yeah, this one is good for because this one includes your party members. That is why this one is also a must have for her. I thought it's only for her, but when I read now, this one is meant for your whole team. So if mono party will deal more damage if you have her, and that's why she's going to be a really really good support for that fire team. Let's talk about her team building. The best team build for her is probably something like this. Let's just do for example so that we have an understanding. This one is the team that I've used in my PBE showcase, and this one is pretty darn good enough even without canon, because not everyone has canon. Her banner is already a long gun. She doesn't have a rerun just yet, but these two have Valentine can be gotten from the selective I believe in the beginner or something. Air already has a lot of rerun banners. These three alone can already clear a lot of content. Just add one more fire here for what do you call this, to build up the chain points and also activate the chain skill, because you cannot activate chain skill if you only have three characters. You need four characters for you to be able to activate the chain skill. As you can see, you must have heroes in all four slots for this feature to be available. So having one more fire here, mono fire is the best team build for her. So usually canon is canon is just broken. Canon plus air combination deals massive damage to the enemy. These two alone are already good enough. If you don't have canon, you can even put Eternal for more CP generation, because Eternal can also gather lots of CP by she can do skill 3 to either skill 1 or skill 2. That one is already a really good skill to gain more chain points. You can even put a tank here if you need a tank, but I don't really think you will be needing a tank anymore. You probably can do this one, because Valentine is a crit rate and critical damage buffer, and then Mero is a attack buffer. Also hits really good if you build her with a DPS build. And then air will just deal more damage if you have both attack buff and the critical rate critical damage buff from Valentine. And then Tamamo is just here for the sustain, for the HOT buff, and then for the strip debuff to the enemy, and also what do you call this, the gaining more chain points to your team. You can do pretty much just mix and match to whatever you need. You don't need the healer, and I don't think there are other 3-star power anymore. There are nothing much. You can even use normal Blada here, but take note that Tamamo no Mai should be the starter one, so that you will be able to fully benefit with her skill set, with her chain skill, because her chain skill is that good, especially against bosses. Yeah, so you just make sure that she is positioned here in the starter, especially if you're doing full auto. Sometimes you forgot the arrangement of the characters here, so you're missing a lot. Well, that is the team building for Tamamo no Mae. She's pretty darn good in PBE. There's really nothing much else to say about her, how good she really is in PBE. But for PBP, I just wish she has something a bit more damage. Her damage is just very poop. Well, let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. And I think that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please leave a like and subscribe. I would really appreciate it if you could help me grow my channel more. And thank you to everyone who are supporting my channel. I appreciate every one of you. Until next time, peace.